This is an instructional video on the checkbook register. You'll see here that this is the Google Sheets version, but then I'll also be going through the Excel version so you can see the differences. The first thing I should note is where all the editable cells are. So you'll see here the categories tab, as well as all of the months from January to December. You can edit anything that's below a primary category. So all of these areas here are editable. And then in each monthly tab, this section here, as well as the checkboxes, and then the notes here, and then the balance as well. Those are the editable sections. On the Google Sheets spreadsheet, you'll see that if you do edit an area that's not meant to be edited, like say the balance, I try to delete this cell, a message will pop up that'll say, heads up, you're trying to edit part of the spreadsheet that shouldn't be changed accidentally. Do you want to edit it anyways? You can press OK, and then that will override the fact that this is protected, and it will delete it or modify it the way that you want it to. But I definitely encourage you not to modify anything that has a formula in it. But if you do want to modify anything else, like a color scheme or whatnot, and that message pops up, please do go ahead. For the Excel version here, the messages that pop up are slightly different. You'll see that in this version, try to delete this. You'll see the cell or chart you're trying to change is on a protected sheet, and to make a change, you have to unprotect the sheet. You might be requested to enter a password. There is no password, but if you do want to modify these cells, you can go to the Review tab and click on Unprotect Sheet. And this will allow you to make any changes to anywhere on the spreadsheet, even if it has a protection on it. If you want to make any changes, please go ahead. And then afterwards, I recommend going back to the Review tab, clicking on Protect Sheet, and then pressing OK, entering no password, and then pressing OK, just so that all the formulas are preserved. Another note is that there are frozen panes throughout. So you'll see here that if you scroll down, these cells above are sticky so that you can see them even if you scroll all the way to the bottom of the spreadsheet. If you don't want to make them stick like this, you can go to the View tab and then click on Freeze and then no rows or no columns. And then for the Excel sheet, you can go to View and then Freeze Panes and Unfreeze Panes if you want to do that. So what's included in this spreadsheet, you'll see here, as we mentioned, there's a Categories tab where you can change all the categories, and then the Monthly tabs from January to December. And this is where you record and reconcile your transactions for each month. I should note that if you are using the Excel version, when you first open up the spreadsheet, you might see a security warning pop up at the top around here, and it will say, or it might say, macros have been disabled, and then it'll say, do you want to enable the content? You can click that button to enable the content, and then you can navigate to all of the tabs accordingly. So the first thing that you should do now that you know the general layout of the spreadsheet is to modify all of these secondary categories to fit your situation, and then navigate to the starting month, whichever one it is. So say it's January, and then enter in your balance here. So you can enter it in, say it's 5,000, and you'll see everything changes accordingly. So that's your beginning balance. And then enter in all of your transaction information. So your date, check number. You'll see here this is a dropdown to select the transaction type, what your description is for that transaction, what the primary category is, what the secondary category is, what the amount is, whether it's a deposit or withdrawal, and then whether or not this transaction has gone through or if it's pending. If you want to add any additional notes for that transaction, you can do that here. You'll notice that if two rows have the exact same information, so for example, this row here, if it's exactly the same as this row here, you'll see that it'll be highlighted just in case it was an error. Back. So once you've entered in all these fields, you'll see that the balance is updated and the summary above will also update to give you an idea of where you're at. If you want to carry the balance forward from month to month, you can enter in the last balance cell. So for example, if your starting month is January, in February, instead of entering in a number, you can enter in equals, I'm just going to pull it over here, you can enter in equals January 1st, which is this tab here, and J1000, which is the last balance cell for January. So you'll see once you enter that in here, the balance will carry forward. So J1000 is literally the last cell on this side of the spreadsheet. And then you can do that for every subsequent month. So for example, you can enter it in here as equals February. And it will carry forward accordingly. I'm just going to delete this because we don't want to include this. And this is a live copy. You can also move around the tabs if you want to reorder them. So for example, you can put this here if you want to. So that it represents where your starting month is and where the last month is for the year for you. I hope this explains how to use the checkbook register. Please let me know if you have any questions, and all the best with your check register template.